Hey folks, welcome back to the channel. It's actually been a while since I posted a tutorial. Unfortunately, things have been a bit busy at work over the past few months. But in this video, I'll be doing a refresher of a video I did not too long ago on how to configure a DHCPv6 server on Juniper devices. Now in this video, I'll be showing the method of performing a stateful configuration of DHCPv6, which essentially allows you to hand out IPv6 addresses from a configured pool. And I'll show you exactly what that looks like in this example. So let's dive into it. All right, so jumping over to the topology, I can see here I have two devices. I have my VEXA device, which will be acting as the DHCPv6 server, and I have my Windows 10 device that'll be acting as the DHCPv6 client. Now I want the VEX device to hand out IP address to this Windows 10 PC on the network of 2003:ABC:1234:0/128. And I want that range to be from 11 to 200. And I'll show you as we configure that in this video. For this demonstration, the Windows 10 PC is currently connected on interface GE003 of the VEX device for VLAN 10. According to this topology, I'll need to configure an IRB interface respectively for that VLAN 10 over on the virtual EX to be the DHCPv6 server. So enough chit chat. Let's go ahead and dive into the actual configuration to bring this all to life. If I hop on the VEX and I go into edit mode, if I do a show, I can see that currently that GE003 interface that we were just looking at is currently configured as an access port for VLAN 10. What I'll go ahead and do to get this all started is configure that IRB interface that I'll be using to act as the DHCPv6 server. So I'll do a set interface, IRB.10, and I'll do family INET6 address. And I want to give it the address, let's see, 2003:ABC:1234:, and everything in between will be a zero. So I'll just do a double colon, and I'll give this the address of 10 on a /128 network. So I'll go ahead and hit enter right there. And now I'll go ahead and associate this IRB interface to that VLAN, VLAN 10. So I'll move under the VLAN configuration. So set VLANs, VLAN 10, and I'll sign the layer 3 interface for this VLAN as IRB.10, the one I just created. So now I'll go ahead and specify the statement within Junos that will allow this device to act as a DHCPv6 server, which is set system services local, let's see, DHCP local server. And if I look at my list of possible completions, I want to do DHCPv6. And if I look at that again, I'll do group. I'll call this group my group, since this is a short demonstration, and I'll associate the interface to this group, which will be IRB.10. So now if I were to do a show system services, I could see that I currently have my DHCPv6 server statement in place stating that the IRB.10 interface that I created will be functioning as a DHCPv6 server. So here's the really fun part. Now we want to configure the range and the scope of how this VEX device in this case goes about handing out those addresses. I'll now go ahead and edit under the access configuration to configure this address assignment pool. So I'll do edit access address assignment V6. I'll give this a name. I'll just call this V6 pool and state family. This will be for INET6. And I'll hit enter. So now if I do a set ? I'll go ahead and state what the prefix is that I'll be handing out addresses for. In this case, that's 2003:1234:ABC:123. Let me double check just to make sure. :0/64. So this will be the overarching prefix that I've been assigned in this lab scenario. And I'll show you how we'll break that down when I configure the range in just a moment. So I went ahead and set the prefix to 2003:ABC:123:006/64. So I'll go ahead and configure the range. I'll do a set range, and I'll call this sales. I'm handing out IP addresses to the sales department for IPv6. So I'll specify low, and this is essentially stating what is the starting point of this IPv6 range. So I want to hand out addresses for 2003:ABC:1234:: starting from address number 11 on a /128. And that just means I only want to pay attention to the address field of the last octet. With an IPv4, you had 4 octets. However, in IPv6, you have 8. And so in this case, I only want to pay attention to that last octet to be able to easily visually observe these addresses being handed out. So I'll go ahead and hit enter here, and I'll swap out low for high, and now state where I want this address pool to stop handing out addresses at, and that'll be 200. All right, so I'll hit enter, and now if I give this a show, just to take a quick glance, so far that looks good. I'll do a set question mark just to see if there's anything else to apply here. I could do set DHCP attributes and then specify something like the DHCP DNS server's IPv6 address, but I won't need that in this case since this is just a test example. So I will exit out of that. That looks good. And there's one last thing that I need to put in place just to bring this all to life, and that's to go under set protocols, router advertisement, specify the interface that I want to listen for router advertisements. In this case, that's IRB.TIM. And I'll also state that I want it to ensure that devices that reach out to this interface attempt to retrieve an IPv6 address using stateful configuration. So the command in Junos would be this manage-configuration parameter. So I'll hit enter there. And now we are good to go. I'll do show pipe compare, and we can just take a look at a glimpse of the changes that will take place. So I have the DHCPv6 local server with the IRB interface. I have my IRB interface configured with an IPv6 address. I have the range of the addresses in which I'll be handing out IPv6 addresses. And I've informed my IRB.TIM interface to listen and respond to router advertisements for IPv6 and to inform clients that are seeking an IPv6 address to use a stateful configuration. And I've also associated that IRB interface as the layer 3 interface for VLAN 10. So this is good to go. All I need to do is commit. But before I do that, I want to hop on this Windows 10 PC and just confirm that I currently am unable to receive an IPv6 address. So I see my Ethernet port is up. I'll hop over to the command prompt and I'll do an ipconfig/all. And here I can see I have a link local address, but I don't have a global IPv6 address beginning with 2003.1.ABC.1.2.3.4. I'll go ahead now, hop over on this VEXA device, and I'll go ahead and commit this configuration. I'll do an exit, and I'll do a show DHCPv6 server statistic. All right, and after a moment there, I can see a solicit came in from the DHCPv6 client, an advertise was sent from the DHCPv6 server. Then the client requested an IPv6 address, and a reply came out from the DHCPv6 server. So all looks good so far. So if I hop on the Windows 10 PC, it should now have an IPv6 address. So I'll do ipconfig/all once more. And here I can see that it successfully received an IP address on the configured subnet 2003.ABC.1.2.3.4:11. And I can also verify that it received it from the VQFX device by running one additional command over here, and that's show DHCPv6 server bindings. And boom, I can see that this address was handed out to the client with this MAC address, which if we take another look over at the PC, matches the physical address of this virtual Windows workstation. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, go ahead and smash that like button and subscribe to the channel. As always, thanks for viewing, and I'll see you in the next one.